Evening all, and welcome to our house. Tonight we're testing the audio setup and have a look at the controls and behaviors of the MP3 module. To connect the amplifier with the MP3 module, we have to solder up a connection cable. Luckily, the connectors on both boards are the same, and the MP3 module came with two. The second one is for aux in, which we're not going to use. As you can see in the background, at double speed, that's done in a couple of minutes with some solder and shrink wrap. Always make sure the shrink wrap sits nicely and that the joints don't come apart when pulling on the wires. As we'll need 12 volt DC, I'm adjusting my variable power supply to the voltage. It's made from an old 18 volt drills charger, a DC-DC converter with current limiting, and a digital LED display ammeter, voltmeter. I'm double checking the voltage and polarity before wiring the DC in up on the amplifier's terminals. When we plug in and power up the MP3 module, we can cycle through the various inputs, but as there is neither USB nor SD card, the playback function is skipped for now. As you can see, there's a small delay while the firmware switches between the different modes. The modules came bare in anti-static pouches, as you might expect. I'm positively surprised at the speakers though. They came in full retail packaging, so let's do a little unboxing. We have a manual and two wires that conveniently have the connectors pre-crimped on one end. There's also a small bag with suitable screws for the covers and mounting the speaker stanchions. The speakers seem solidly built and have a decent weight. 381 grams each without cover. The cover seems strong enough for the purpose as well. It's time to wire the speakers up. For now, I'll just twist the bare ends and clamp them into the terminals. Once inside the box, they'll have to be shortened a good width anyway. As a surprise, one terminal was missing or came loose because it wasn't crimped properly when I untangled the wires. But after a quick trip to the garage, we have a suitable replacement tightly crimped on to complete the wiring. I've also loaded some MP3s and a FLAC file onto a regular SD card, so we have something to play. I'm not hiding all the mistakes I make. As you can see, I didn't plug in the connection cable, which was the reason why we didn't hear anything. The speakers are quite directional. We'll have to see how they behave in the finished box in the end. The module's volume has 30 levels, which we can see on the FLAC file. There's no noticeable distortion, and the little amplifier board produces a nice sound without getting warm at all. I'm pretty sure I'd use this type of TA2024 module again. It lives up to its reputation of providing good value for money. It also seems quite efficient. At a first glance, the power consumption looks to be around 100 milliamps or so. We'll have a closer look in a future video. That's it for now. Next time we'll have a close look at the MP3 module, which includes taking it apart, of course. Thanks for watching.